So in this video, I'm going to show you how to convert the input seconds into hours, minutes, and seconds. So I'm going to do this program both in C and C++, but I think irrespective of the language, everyone can watch this program, as the main thing is the logic. Only the input and printing is going to change language-wise, but the logic is going to remain the same. I think everyone can watch this video. So let's get started. So first I will do this program in C++, and then I will do it in C, okay? Hash include IO string. No, hash, okay, hash. Using name space std, using space and it's going to be int main. So many space mistakes. Okay, so using namespace string, right? So first I'm going to just input the seconds. So it has to be the seconds. Cout and enter the seconds, enter to new line. Okay, C in, yes. So that's it. So now what we're going to do is we're converting into hour, seconds, and minutes. So we need another three more variables. So it's going to be int hr, min, and acc. So the first thing, main thing that we need to know is 1 hour equal to 3600 seconds. So that's enough. That's going to be the base for all the things that we're calculating. And obviously, everyone will be knowing 1 minute is 60 seconds. So that's it. So for hour conversion, it's basically that as simple as I told you, 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. We're just going to directly divide the input seconds by 3600. So hour will be equal to s/3600. So that's it. We have found the hour. And second, next I will find the second. Okay, it will be second equal to input seconds modulus 60. Okay. So what I'm doing is that if that, for example, it's about 3610, the input is, we obviously know that the 10 is only going to be a second. Okay, 3610 is actually 1 hour and 10 seconds. So what we need is the remaining seconds that isn't divisible by 60. So that's what second equal to S mod 60 does, just gives the remainder to us. So that's why. So next thing is the minute. Okay, we'll do minute. Last minute will be equal to the input seconds by 60. Okay, as we know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, we will do that s/60. Okay, but here's the twist there. There's an error actually here. I will show you the error and I will change it. It's a simple logic that has been isn't applied, so I will say you how to change it. So, next is just printing cout. I will print in that format hour hr. It's going to be min and it's going to be second. So I think that's holds good for everything. Let me just run it. So how much can I give? I will give 3050. Okay, so this is about 0 hours and 50 minutes and 50 seconds. So as you can see here, I've got hour 0, 50 minutes. Okay, so now you can see this program works really well, but I haven't entered that wrong value. Okay, so this is basically I've entered the correct number for this program. Suppose I will show you this error. This is the error that I told you it will happen. Suppose what if I enter any number above 3600? Suppose let me enter just 3600 6700. Okay, you need to return 1 hour, 1 minute and 40 seconds, okay? But we will return 61 minutes. As we have entered, minute is equal to S by 60, just returns the divided by 60, so at 61, okay? 61 into 60 will give 3660, so that's why it's written like that. So this minute statement will not work for all the values, okay? Let me show you another demo also. This one will be better, understand? Let me put 3600 itself, so you should return thus 1 hour, but what we will get is 1 hour 60 minutes and 0 seconds. So as I told you, so we need to change this code, line of code over here. Okay, so the simplest way of doing this is, what we need to do is we need to put second. Okay, this second, the input second is equal to second mod 3600. That's it. This one line of code makes a program completely generic for all numbers. First it was below 3600, now it's completely generic for all numbers. So we got a problem for minute s, minute equal to s plus 60 when our s value was greater than or equal to 3600. Okay, so our minute value worked fine, and when s value was less than 3600, now it caused problems when s value was greater than 600. So what this line of code does is it basically converts the s value less than 3600. Suppose let us take this example itself. What error did we got? 3700 was a mistake, I think. So for 3700 we got a mistake. So this basic, this line of code does is 3700 mod 3600, so which will basically return 100. Okay, so the next line is going to be 100 slash 60 will be 1. So basically we have got the required answer. Now this one single line of code has changed the entire course of this program. So now let me show you again, and again and show you the same output. I ran 3700, okay, 3700, and now you can see here 1 hour 1 minute and 40 seconds, 3600 plus 60 plus 40. So now you have got the answer. So let me run another program as well. Let me do 7500, which is about 2 hours and 5 minutes, as you can see here. So this works fine. Okay,
well, that's it. C++ program is currently over, so I told you I will also do it in C. So just a couple of changes. So basically I go and take this, put it void over here. I think you can do it this on your own, so okay, anyway, I'll do it. It's going to be printf. Special for the bank. Scanf percentage D. So these are right, these are right. So next, the last thing we're printing. Percentage D. And percentage D over here, close it, comma, HR, comma, min, comma, ICC. So I've run, I need to uncompile it. Okay, so now let me run it. You would compile and run. 7250 will do. So that's it, I've got this output 2 hours 50 seconds. Okay, 3600 plus 3600 plus 50, 7250. That's it. Thanks for watching. Also check out my other tutorials on other programming languages from my playlist or my video list of my channel. Thanks for watching.